Today we are going to travel in the first underground water metro of India, which is in Kolkata. It is a 16.55 kilometer long project and it was commissioned back in 2004. It took time because there were a lot of challenges the official had to face, ranging from the structure of the soil and the fact that it had to be built 30 meters below the Hooghly River. But now majority of the project is going to be completed by December 2023. The officials have assured us. So let's go ahead and know about their journey.
The eagerly awaited metro goes through a tunnel covering a length of 520 meters underneath the Hooghly River, a distributary of the Ganga that cuts through the twin cities of Howrah and Kolkata. The metro exists in the section that will connect Howrah Maidan and Esplanade stations and will be open for commercial services by December this year.
Unique features of this project is the first time in this country the tunnels have been taken under such a mighty river, Hooghly, which is a perennial river. And the second unique feature is it is having the deepest metro station in the country, Howrah metro station, which is at the lowest level of which is 30 meters below ground level.
The underwater metro tunnel is a part of the larger east-west metro corridor costing about 10.44 crore that starts from Sector 5 of Salt Lake, an IT hub in the east, and ends at Howrah Maidan in the west across River Hooghly.
Karunamayi, uske baad Central Park, uske baad City Center, uske baad Bengal Chemical, uske baad Salt Lake Stadium. This entire stretch is elevated. After that, there is a ramp. Before Phulbagan station, the elevated becomes underground. Phulbagan to Shialdah, yaha pe it is hidden by the microphone, Shialdah station, and up to Howrah Maidan, it is totally underground. Yeah. Howrah Maidan is there. Presently, in phases, the section from Salt Lake, Sector 5 to Shialdah has been opened for commercial services. Gaadiya chal rahi hai. Aur abhi Shialdah station se Howrah Maidan tak kaam chal raha hai. Work is in progress. As per present planning, we intend to start commercial service, a truncated of course commercial service from Esplanade to Howrah Maidan. Because there are some technical issues which are yet to be fully tackled between Esplanade and Shialdah station.
Okay, sir, let us go beneath
the... Now, just to have an overview, this is the full overview of the section. I will ask you to please see the next model. This will give you a very clear picture of the tunnel.
Kolkata was the first city in India to have a metro line, which started in 1984, covering over the north-south axis. However, the east-west corridor took a long time to build, missing more than 7 deadlines due to various technical and political interferences, such as the state government pulling out of the project. But now that it's nearing completion, officials believe the future looks promising.
Howrah Maidan, Howrah and up to Salt Lake mein traffic congestion kafi, road traffic congestion kafi zyada hai. Kareeb usme kareeb 1.5 ghante kareeb time lagte hai for passengers from Howrah area to Salt Lake area. After executing commissioning of this metro, travel time will drastically reduce up to say around 35 to 40 minutes. That will save huge time of public.
जो कलकत्ता के दोनों हावड़ा और कलकत्ता इन दोनों को सीमलेस कनेक्टिविटी हो जाएगी बिलो द रिवर. एट प्रेजेंट सिर्फ 2 ब्रिजेस हैं जिससे लोग पार होते हैं. एग्जिस्टिंग ब्रिजेस हैं उनमें काफ़ी प्रॉब्लम्स होती है क्योंकि रश आवर में काफ़ी ट्रैफिक होती है. जेटी सर्विसेज हैं लेकिन वो भी इंटरमिटेंट है. तो मेट्रो जब सर्विसेज चालू हो जाएंगी तो पब्लिक के पास एक जैसे ही हावड़ा स्टेशन उतरे, हावड़ा इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेशन, वहाँ उतरे आराम से मेट्रो में आ जाएंगे एंड दे कैन कनेक्ट विद
अदर पार्ट्स
एग्जिस्टिंग मेट्रो नेट.
The idea of an underwater metro tunnel goes back to when the British government first planned it but eventually dropped the idea due to its high cost. The underwater tunnel that is now 100 years in making was built in a record 66 days time. Officials said when construction was in full swing, about 200 engineers and 15,000 laborers were working round the clock to overcome the mammoth task.
Depth of the top of the tunnel from the bottom of the river is 15 meters.
and the average depth of water is 13 meters.
Driving the tunnel below the river Hooghly, because Hooghly River is a perennial river, it has water all the year round. The first layer was sandy soil just below water, where tunneling was not possible because of the rapid flow. Fortunately, we encountered a clay layer just below that. The tunnel has been founded in the clay layer. And of course, in an underwater situation, the pressure changes very because of the depth of water and so many other factors. But fortunately, there was no such untoward incident there.
There have been numerous challenges in building the underground tunnel for the metro, not just in the section that runs through the mighty and perennial river, but in other sections as well that require taking special precautions to not affect old and fragile structures.
For construction of metro in heavily density area is a big challenge. One more challenge is different soil strata at very close interval is different. That is, soil strata is erratic. Where tunneling below such a big yard like Howrah yard and Sialdah yard, that is another big challenge. Tunneling below old and deliberated buildings या national monuments, इसके नीचे tunneling करने में काफ़ी challenges थे, तो उसको counter करने के लिए काफ़ी measures लिए गए थे और accordingly हम लोगों ने successful completion of tunneling किया है with the help of experts available in India as well as from abroad.
Between Howrah and Howrah Maidan, there is a road over bridge called Bankim Sethu Road Over Bridge. Their foundation piles were infringing. Exact millimeter to millimeter survey was done, and so that the two tunnels were constructed between the piles without infringing the piles.
Train is departing.
Similarly, when you come to the Kolkata side, there is a Brabourne Road flyover, which is also an existing flyover. It had to come under that without in any way affecting the foundation piles of that existing flyover. And we encountered maybe 150 year old buildings on the alignment. During the construction of the tunnel, those buildings were instrumented for any tilt, settlement, shift, instrumented. And for as a matter of abundant precaution, the people living there were temporarily shifted to other places so that there is no untoward incident.
Keeping in mind all the challenges it can pose in the future, there are provisions made available throughout the tunnel as per international standard.
There is a linear heat detection system in throughout the tunnel, by which we are monitoring the temperature of the tunnel, and mapping is available for every 25 meters of the tunnel temperature at the OCC. OCC means Operation Control Center. And there will be alarm after a set temperature of 45 degrees. So we can detect, we can inquire about why the temperature has risen, and we can take a necessary action urgently.
So I hope it was informative for you and you could understand more about the project. This is Sukriti Vats for The Print.